Hello React Native developers, what is going on? In this episode, our animation values are colors, and that should be quite some fun. So welcome to Can It Be Done in React Native. This week, we set the mood. Hello guys, I hope you are well. William here, recording from beautiful Zurich, Switzerland. In this week's episode, we're looking at the Philips Hue color selection. Philips Hue are smart light bulbs you can have in your home, and you can set the color and the intensity of the light bulb through the app. And when I first saw this example, I got really excited for three reasons. First is that in the Can It Be Done React Native series, we often use animation values to express some sort of transformation, a scale, a rotation, or a translation. And here, our animation values are going to be colors, which is kind of new and I think quite exciting. The second reason I got excited is that obviously there is some sort of trigonometry involved, right? As soon as you see some sort of rotation or something circular, there is trigonometry involved. And here, in order for the pin to nicely be draggable within the circle, we're going to use trigonometry. That's obviously an example we've done before, or at least we've done very similar circular examples with the pan gesture handler. And the last reason I got really excited is that in order to build the, it's not really a gradient, but the background circle, it looks like we're going to need to use OpenGL. And last time we used OpenGL on this channel, that was quite some fun. And here it looks like a very simple OpenGL shader that we can write. So how do we do this in React Native? Well, there are three parts to this problem. First, there is a background circle that we're going to build using an OpenGL shader. And then there is a pin that we can drag around within the bound of the circle. And we need to interpolate its background color to match the position. And finally, the last part is this slider here to set the intensity of the light. So let's talk quickly about the OpenGL shader. So this is actually what we're trying to build as a background circle. And here is the saturation new color spectrum. So in order to first build such a shader, we're gonna look at the position of each pixel. And this is the coordinate system of my OpenGL Canva. So the top left pixel is at 0, 0. Top right is at 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, yeah. So first, if the pixel is outside the bound of this circle, it's transparent. And if not, we calculate its color. So if distance of XY from the center, which is at 0,5, 0,5, so from 0,5, 0,5 is greater than 1, pixel is transparent, else the color of the pixel is, so in the U saturation value color space, it's going to be, the U is the angle of the position. So it's going to be A tan of Y X. The saturation is going to be the radius. So it's going to be distance from the center. So let's distance from center. And the value is going to be 1. So here we have the U saturation value color, which we need to convert into an RGB color. So this is actually quite easy to do. There are some functions we can use here. And this is the one we're going to use. But actually, if you want to build such conversion manually, because, you know, just for fun, It's actually very well explained in Wikipedia. So here you have the graph here of each coordinates. So for each U and saturation value, you have the coordinates of red, blue, green. And I think it's explained also here. And so this we can easily convert to RGB, and that's going to give us this nice circle. But obviously you see that here it looks a bit different because the white tones are much bigger. And so what we're going to use here is that instead of having linear saturation, we're going to use some interpolation to the saturation. So I think I should have some easing functions here. So what we want is that you see that at the end of the circle, it looks pretty linear, but then the white values are much more bigger than here. So we want something that starts very slow, but that ends almost like a straight line. So something like this looks good. Maybe it might be too harsh. But I see two here that looks good. See is in scene or is in quad, because it starts slow and then it ends really like almost like a straight line. Actually, I cannot even tell the difference between the two, but I'm gonna use is in quad because it's a very simple easing function. And this is gonna give us exactly this result. So that's for the OpenGL part. Then we need to drag the pin around. So we have a pan gesture handler for the pin, which we move around, and we have X and Y coordinate. We're going to convert it into a polar coordinate. So we're going to get an angle and radius, and we're going to set the radius value maximum to be 1, or to be, in the case, because here we are doing this outside the OpenGL Canva, it's not 0, 1, but it's 0 and maximum radius of the view. So we're going to set the radius of this new coordinate. So for instance, here, my finger is here. And we have a alpha and a radius value. We set the radius to be the maximum radius value. And we convert back this polar coordinate into translation. So X and Y. And this is going to give us the pin to clamp exactly on a circular shape. And then, so this is to move the pin around and to interpolate its color. We're going to do exactly the same thing that we did in OpenGL, but we've reanimated. And this means that we need to also convert U-saturation value colors into RGB colors. And this, we're going to do it through Redash. So this is the function we're going to use in our OpenGL shader to convert from HSV to RGB, and I wrote the same function in reanimated. So this is the exact same code. You see, I took line by line and rewrote the function. So we make sure that we interpolate the color in the same manner, and they should look identical. And so this is saturation U, and then we have the value a component, which goes from 0 to 1. And we're going to animate this animation value through a little slider that we're going to build with the pan gesture handler, which is the last part. So what do you guys think? Can it be done in React Native? Let's have a look. Before we get started, one thing, if you are interested to learn the fundamental of gestures and animations in React Native, I recommend that you check out my online course at startreactnative.dev. My goal with this course is to provide you with all the tools and knowledge necessary in order to build incredible user experiences in React Native that will run at 60 FPS, even on low-grade Android devices. After following this curriculum, the recipes we tackle in the Can It Be Done React Native series should feel absolutely trivial. You should have all the animation and gesture tool belt in order to tackle all these complex gestures and animations. So if you're interested to learn the fundamentals, I recommend you check it out at startreactnative.dev. All right, guys, let's get started. Here I have a boilerplate project, which you can download from the video description in case you want to follow along with this example. And here I have a simple OpenGL shader that we wrote a couple of weeks ago on this channel. I just copy paste it. So here we wrote a simple angular gradient, but we're going to modify it to have our hue saturation background circle. So let's do this. Here we have the magnitude of the UV vector from the center. So UV is a pixel for which we need to calculate the color, so via glfragColor, and we take the distance from the center of the circle. Again, the coordinate go from 0 to 1 horizontally and 0 to 1 vertically. This distance from the center is going to be the saturation of our color. I mean, here it's going to, because it goes from 0 to 1, the magnitude goes from 0 to 0.5, so the radius, and we need to have it go from 0 to 1. The saturation goes from 0 to 1, so we'll have saturation S is magnitude times 2. The U is the angle formed by the coordinate of the pixel. So here we remove 0.5 from the UV pixel, so we have the radius of the circle formed by the pixel. So we do a tan of y over x, and that gives us h, which is the u. The u here goes from, so the a tan function with overload 2 in OpenGL goes from minus pi to pi. And this is how we convert it into a value that goes from 0 to 1. We can do it quickly. So we have a, which is from minus pi to pi. So we would have a plus pi, which goes from 0 to pi. And then we would do a plus pi divided. No, that would go to, from 0 to 2 pi. So we add a pi on each side. And so then to go from 0 to 1, we would divide by 2 pi. So we would have a plus pi divided by 2 pi that goes from 0 to 1, which is essentially what we have here. So this is going to be the U, actually. This one is alpha, let's call it. So start and color, we don't need. So if the magnitude is greater than 0.5, we have a transparent pixel. If not, we have our U saturation value color, which we're going to convert into an RGB color. So I'm going to do, so we need a function to convert from RGB to, from U saturation value to RGB. I'm going to copy this function here and do the conversion. So we have vector 3, we have U saturation value is 1. Let's have a look. So our circle looks good, but we need to have some easing on the saturation, so it's much, much lower at the beginning. And I can simply do, actually, saturation power 2 is going to be the quadratic is in. So you see here now it looks exactly like on the Philips U. It starts slow and then goes linearly towards the end. So that's our OpenGL shader. All right, so now let's implement the dragging of the pin around the circle. So here I have the picker component and my pin is a simple SVG, which I wrapped into a view to have some shadow. So we're gonna wrap it into a pan gesture handler from React Native Gesture Handler. And the first and only child of a pan gesture handler needs to be an animated view from Reanimated. So I'm gonna transform here view to be animated.view. Here as well, and we need to create the couple of animation values. We need X and Y for the translation. So I'm going to create a translation vector. So we use vec from redash to. So this simply creates an X and Y animation value. And we need the state of the gesture so we can remember the position of the pin across gestures. So state is new value, default value is state.undetermined. So we can create our gesture handler. Again, here we use redash to have some boilerplate done for us. So we have translation x is translation.x, translation y is translation.y, and the state of the gesture, which we can, I need to import reanimated here. We can pass gesture handler here. So now if I have, I can create, I'm gonna use with offset to remember the position of the pin across gesture, and then we're gonna use it as the transform of this view to see if it works. So I'm gonna create a vector called translation x is, or trx, or translation with offset. Translation with offset. So we're gonna use with offset for translation x. We pass the state of the gesture, and for translation y. And we can apply it as a translation to the view. So we're gonna use translate from redash, again simple helper function to have the translate x and translate y automatically. Yes, states. So I can drag it around, no problem. Now we need to limit, we need to do two things. We want the default here maybe to be the middle of the circle, and we want to not be able to drag the pin outside the boundaries of the circle. So here I could, to have it at the center, I can add to the translation with offset vector the center of the screen. So here I have a center vector, which is the center of the view. So it's vector add from redash. So I can use this vector as a translation now. So here, the top left corner is at the center. So we just need to translate half of the height of the pin and half of the width of the pin. So let me just do that. And I'm gonna translate. So x is picker width divided by 2, height is picker height divided by 2. Let's have a look. Minus. So now that's perfectly at the center. Let's add some boundaries. So what we're gonna do is convert this coordinate into polar coordinates. And so we're gonna have theta and radius. So again, here we use redash to have these values. So we're gonna do canva coordinates to polar. So we pass the trx translation vector center of the canva, and theta is gonna be theta. Radius, we're gonna clamp it to the half of the canvas, to the radius of the circle, which is canvas size divided by 2, and convert back these coordinates to canvas coordinates so we can do the translation. So, polar translation is, so theta is theta, and radius, we're gonna clamp radius here. So we're gonna clamp radius from 0 to canvas size divided by 2. And we can apply these polar coordinates here, so by converting so polar to canvas and center. Let's have a look. So here you see I can drag around and I cannot go outside the bounds of the circle. It's pretty cool, no? Now we can do the color interpolation. So I'm gonna create, we have three components to our colors. Hue, saturation, value. Here we only use hue and saturation, value is 1. So I'm gonna create H for hue, S for saturation, and V for value. And we're gonna convert this free anime value default is gonna be 1. And we're gonna use R, use saturation value to color to have the background color. So this is a function from Redash. And I just used the implementation we used in this shader, which I rewrote in Reanimated. So now we have here the color component. We pass it as parameter and we need to pass also hue and saturation in the picker so we can modify its value from the picker. So this one becomes an animated node and we get hue also, which is an animated, it's an animated value because we're going to modify actually its value and saturation. So we have hue saturation. Now that background color becomes a animation value and not a string, path needs to become an animated path. I think here I'm gonna set it as a string here for now. It's not handled as an animation value in the header. So now we can interpolate according to the position, the saturation and the hue, and we can set it to the these two values. So the hue we need to convert, and I think we go from minus pi to pi. So I'm gonna normalize it to 0 to 2 pi by using modulo 2 pi. And we want it, so this is gonna go from 0 to 2 pi, and we want it to have from 0 to 1, so I'm gonna divide it by 2 pi. And saturation, we're gonna divide the radius, which is this value here. Let me call this polar. Theta is polar dot theta. This one is radius. So I'm gonna create radius is clamp of polar.radius from 0 to canva size divided by 2. And here we're gonna divide radius by canva size divided by 2. So we go from 0 to 1. And so this one is polar.theta. And we're gonna assign these values to H and S using use code. So we can execute a block of code for every frame. And so we're going to use set H2U and saturation to S. No dependencies in the hook. Let's have a look. So here you see the color is nicely interpolated almost. You see here because, for instance, I have some light blue, but I'm almost white. It's because in the shader, we used some interpolation, some easing function, which we need to use here as well. So I'm gonna use saturation, so power 2. So here we really have exactly the same color interpolation between OpenGL and Reanimated. Last step, now let's deal with the header here. So I have the header component, we're gonna pass the background color and we're gonna need the HSV value. So I can background color becomes an animated node. The value V animated value because we're going to modify it from the header. And then we have H and S. So this one becomes an animated view. Oops. We need also to have it in slider. Animated node. And these needs to be animated views. So now the color interpolates. So we need the text here to be black if the color is too light, and redash provides a function for it. So if I go in the header, this is where the text here is always white. So I'm gonna transform it into an animated text. And interpolate the color according to background color. And so in redash, it's called color for background. We pass the background color as parameter. So let me import it. So I'm gonna create the RGB components and I'm gonna use HSV2RGB HS, and I'm gonna use 1 for the value and I'm gonna pass it here as parameter. Let's have a look. So now it's dark. Here it's dark, it becomes white or black according to the value. So that's perfect. Now let's animate our little slider here. So if I go into slider, I can wrap the cursor into a pan gesture handler. Same deal. This one needs to be an animated view. We create the gesture handler. So we need the translation X, the state of the gesture. Default is undetermined. State is from React Native Gesture Handler. So gesture handler. We use on event from redash. So we translation X state. Translation translate X. We're gonna use with offset to remember the position of the slider across touches. So we give translation X and state as parameter. And we can apply it. So we pass the gesture handler here. And we can apply the transformation here, translate X, which we need to clamp to go from 0 to the width minus the width of the cursor. It's, I have a variable, I think, here called upper bound, which is width minus size of the cursor. So I can import clamp from redash here. Doesn't look too happy. 0 to upper bound. So, up. I am not able to drag it around. Translation. Oh, it's transform, translate X. Okay. I can move it around, and now depending on the value, we're gonna set the V component of the color. So I should pass it as parameter here. It's an animated value. So we're going to use code, and we set V to B. So to go from 0 to 1, so we're going to divide translate X to upper bound, because translate X goes from 0 to upper bound. No dependencies. Up. So that's perfect. We just need to set maybe the default value to be 1. So maybe I can add an offset here. And I'm going to set offset to be default value upper bound. So I can select a color, so use saturation and select the value. Isn't that cool? I mean, here actually we can either we could use the value here component instead of using one. So here you see if it gets darker. And I can just move it around and the text is always visible. Isn't that cool? Wow. Guys, I hope you enjoyed this example. This is the first time we used colors as animation values. And I think that we went quite deep into the topic. It was fun to use a simple OpenGL shader and then we converted the conversion function from HSV to RGB in Reanimated, and so we interpolate colors to position both in OpenGL and in React Native, and we had exactly the same interpolations. So that was great. We also built the circular clamping on the pin, so it cannot go outside the bounds of the circle. This is a recipe that we've used already in previous videos, and it's nice to see now how comfortable we are to apply such a recipe when we see a new example that involves some sort of a circular gesture. So yeah, let me know what you think in the comments below. I'm looking forward to talk to you soon. And in the meantime, happy hacking.